Peace. Welcome to Faith Expressions. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. In this video, we are going to discuss about how we, Catholic adults, should approach the Scriptures, because we have to have a good disposition and a good mindset in order to read the Scriptures in the way that is also coherent to the teachings of our Mother Church. And so I have four ways in approaching the Bible, the Scriptures. First and foremost, very important, the Bible is not a book, it's not one book, but rather it's many books. It is a library, not one book, but books. Very important that we have to bear this in mind, so that right away, at the very beginning, we know what kind of disposition we have in reading the Scriptures. When we say there are many books, so we will not treat it as if when I read one book, it will be the same manner as I read other books. There are many books. So there are many literary genre, there are many styles, there are many kinds of books. And if there are many kinds of books, therefore we do not read one book in the same way as you read another book. Like when I read the book of Psalms, it will not be the same as I will read, for example, the book of the prophet Isaiah, or the book of the Gospels, for example, the Gospel of St. Matthew. So, different books, different kinds, different literary genre. When we also say that there are books, we also will bear in mind there are different authors. And when there are different authors, then also we will say, oh, there are different moods, different cultural background. The author, how his style in writing, how his mentality of the time, their mentality the time, or the language he is using. All of this has to be taken into consideration, because there are many books. Another thing with the different books is the idea of the time. When therefore there are many books, so there are also different times of writing. The Bible was not written as if in one time. No, the books of the Bible were written in different times, and therefore different audiences as well. So we have to bear this in mind, and this is very important, so that we do not just read and understand the Bible as if, oh, this is my interpretation. Oh, this is what it says. No. That is why the second idea I would like us to pay attention, as Catholic adults, we read the Scriptures with the idea that interpretation does not belong to us, does not belong to private individuals in the Catholic faith, but rather the interpretation is only from the Magisterium of the Church. Magisterium, magister is teacher, from the teaching body of the Church, from the Pope, the bishops. They read and interpret the Scriptures coherent with the tradition, with the sacred tradition that was handed down from the earliest in our Christianity, from the time of the apostles to the time of the apostolic fathers to the fathers of the Church, etc. So they have a consistent teaching about, for example, a passage. How is this passage being read? And how is this passage understood, for example, during the time of the apostles, during the time of the fathers of the Church, during the time, for example, in the 15th century, in our time, in the interpretation of the Bible? There is this consistency. And that is why we need a teaching body for interpretation. It is not into our responsibility as individual Catholics, as individual faithful, that we will read it and we will understand it for ourselves. Because many heads will have many different interpretations. And the Bible, instead of bringing us together, it will lead us to separate each other. And precisely that is what happens with the Reformation churches. Instead of bringing them together, all the more they are being into different denominations. And so for us in the Catholic mindset, we approach the Bible not with the mentality to interpret the Bible, read and interpret. No. We read and we translate into works. We translate into action, transforming our lives, the words in the scriptures, to modify and change our behavior, our conduct. And that is why here, if for example, there are passages that are hard to understand, we do not interpret it according to, oh, this is how I understand it. No, we refer to the Magisterium of the Church. We talk to a priest. We read what has been said in our catechism, from the writings of the Church Fathers, etc. The Magisterium of the Church is the official teacher and interpreter of the Scriptures. The third point I would like us to bear in mind is the Bible can never teach error. The Bible contains truth of God and truth about our life in relation to God. The Bible never will deceive people and so that their lives will be lived out in a way that is contrary to God. Some time ago, I heard a person saying, well, Father, the Bible teaches something erroneous. I said, why? Because it says the Bible also is written there saying that there is no God. Well, wait a moment, I said. Let us go to that passage. And that passage in the book of Psalms, it says, the fool says in his heart, there is no God. So why are you going to just read there is no God? It is error, of course. But it doesn't mean that that is what the Bible is teaching. The Bible is teaching, saying that the fool says in his heart, there is no God. So we do not read the scriptures and understand the scriptures in a way that it will suit our own mentality, our lifestyle, to suit only our comforts. No. We first bear in mind what we said in the preceding point. The interpretation belongs to the Magisterium. Now for us, we take from the Bible with the mindset. The Bible will teach us truths. And these truths is about God and about our life. When we read and meditate and pray with the Bible, then our lives more and more will be pleasing to the Lord because we will change our lives for the better as the words of God will lead us to walk in the right path. The fourth and the last point I would like us to consider, the Bible is a good source for our prayer life. The Bible is a good companion to our prayer life. In fact, the Bible has the book of Psalms. And the book of Psalms is the source of prayer, not only from the Old Testament people, but especially in our church. The breviary is the book of prayers with the different Psalms that are in the Bible. So also, it is important as well to note this, that many times we pass through dryness in prayer life. We don't want to pray. We do not have the kind of willingness to pray. Well, read the Bible. And many times for me, I like my favorite passages. And the favorite passages, depending on, say, my personal feelings at the time, I would call them to mind and start with that. For example, you feel tired, you feel beaten, so to say, by life. So I start by saying, "Come to me, all you who are weary and find life burdensome, and I will refresh you." I will repeat that. That's the words of the Lord Jesus Christ. And then also, sometimes I would repeat the words from the scriptures. In the world, you will have troubles, but do not be afraid. I have conquered the world. Sometimes I would repeat that so that I can enter into a good disposition for prayer. Or I like always another passage is like the deer that longs for running streams of water. So my soul is yearning for you, my God. You can have your favorite Bible verses and let them accompany you in your prayer life so that we will never lose the fondness as well and the energy and enthusiasm in our prayer life. The Bible is a good source for prayer. The Bible is a good companion to prayer life. In conclusion, with the Bible having a good disposition to approach it, we will learn so much from the Word of God in order that our behavior, our attitude, our mentality can change for the better. Secondly, with the Bible, we always know when we read and pray with the Bible, we become fond of the Word of God. We become fond of God Himself. We become fond of the Lord Jesus Christ who speaks to us. We will have a better appreciation and understanding of what matters to God so that these that matters to God, we will live out in our daily life. And so, read your Bible and be in love of the Bible. And maybe as you will be in love of the Bible, all the more, we will be in love of God. We will be in love of the Lord Jesus Christ. And the Holy Spirit that is in us, the love of God the Father and the Son, He will inspire us more from the words of God that we read in the Scriptures. God bless. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you for listening, and please subscribe if you have not done so, and share this video to others, and stay tuned for other adult faith formation topics. God bless.